Today we are going to discuss about the network theorem. Basically, this is the part of the electrical engineering. So, while studying the electrical engineering, we study some elementary subjects like the circuit theory. In circuit theory, we generally analyze the any circuit. When we talk about the analyzing of any circuit, what does it mean? When we talk about the in any circuit, what? There is a current and there is a voltage in any branch. So, the question is how to find out the value of voltage and value of current in any branch of the circuit. In branch of the circuit means in any element of that branch. That is basically here. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about some theorems. First, we will see the one application of the Norton's theorem. According to this Norton's theorem, we can make a equivalent circuit, equivalent network from this complicated network which is having only one current source, which is with the parallel equivalent impedance. This one current source is generally called ISC, the short circuit current source, and the equivalent impedance, which is the equivalent impedance of the whole network, this is generally called as Rn, R Norton. So, here we will see one problem based on the Norton's theorem, from where you will be able to understand this theorem very clearly. So, here let us see this. Determine the voltage across 200 ohm resistor in circuit by Norton's theorem. Here this is a network which is having the current source of 10 volt and current, this is the voltage source, this is the current source of 1 ampere and the resistances. Now, by Norton's theorem, this across this AB, we can change this whole network into a single current source and a parallel impedance. And then we can connect this 200 ohm again and we can find out the voltage across this. First of all, we have to make the Norton equivalent circuit from this complicated network across the terminal A and B. The question is how to make this equivalent circuit. Equivalent circuit means with a one, find the value of one current source and the one parallel impedance. Step 1 for this. Find the short circuit current ISC, which is because this is the Norton's theorem having Norton's equivalent circuit having one equivalent volt current source here. Now, question is how to find out the value of this ISC. For finding the value of ISC, first of all, we have to short circuit the terminal AB where the 200 ohm resistance was there, from where we have to find out the current. So, we are short circuiting this terminal A and B. If we find out the current through this AB, and that will be the value of the ISC or value of the current source, equivalent current source for the Norton's equivalent. So, current is, this is the short circuit path. The one current is flowing because of this 10 volts source, which is driving the current from here, here and here. 1 ampere current source, which is driving the current in this path, see this path. And the total current through this AB path will be the summation of the current because of this 10 volt source and the 1 ampere source. So, here because of this 10 volt, we can say what is this? The voltage source will drive the current of 10 divided by 50 V by R here is equal to 0.2 ampere. So, this 0.2 ampere current will flow through this because of this 10 volt. Then second, because of this 1 ampere, see 1 ampere current will go through this path here and it is having a two path here, one path is this, another path is this. Definitely the current will choose this path because this is the least resistance path, because current always follow the least resistance path. So, here the whole 1 ampere current will flow through this path, not this path. The total current ISC is equal to, this is 0.2 plus 1 is equal to 1.2 ampere. So, this is the short circuit current we can say, or this is the equivalent current of this Norton's equivalent circuit. Now, we have to find out the equivalent, we have said that this is the Norton's equivalent circuit is having the one current source and the parallel resistance or impedance. So, here first of all we have to find what is the value of this parallel, this impedance, the equivalent impedance. Just like a Thevenin theorem, where we have find out the, we have to find out the value of RTH. So here, what is the procedure for finding this RTH or R Norton? At this step, first of all, we will make it open circuit where the 200 ohm resistance was there, and all the sources are replaced by their internal resistance. Here, there were the what? Voltage source. So voltage source replaced by the short circuit, and the here there were current source, and current source replaced by the open circuit. See, this is the internal resistance of the, this for the ideal current source. So here this is infinity, that is why we are replacing it by the open circuit. Internal impedance of this of the this ideal voltage source is 0, that is why we are replacing it by the short circuit. This is the impedance as seen from the load terminal, from terminal AB. We are drawing the Norton's equivalent circuit. This Norton's equivalent circuit is having the one current source and the one parallel resistance. So here we see we have found out the value of ISC 1.2 ampere. We have already found out the value of RTH, which is here. Then just connect the this RL at terminal AB. We have converted this whole complicated network into a Norton's equivalent circuit, which is having the one current source and the one equivalent resistance, where we in step 1 we have seen how to find out the value of ISC current source, and step 2 we have seen that how to find out the value of this equivalent resistance. Now what is our question? We have to find out the current through this, because we want to find out the voltage across this RL. Here the that means for finding the current through this path, we can say we can apply the current division rule. This current is flowing through this path and this path. Apply the current division rule. From the current division rule, you will know that this IL, the current through this path, is equal to total current ISC multiplied by this resistance RTH, or we can say RN, the same thing, because for Thevenin and Norton's theorem are dual to each other. For find the method for finding the this equivalent resistance is same in the case of Thevenin theorem and in the Norton's theorem. That's why we can sometimes we write RTH and sometimes we write RN. So here this is the ISC RN divided by RN plus RL from the current division rule. Put the values here. So here this is the IL. We have to find out the voltage across this. So IL multiplied by RL. When we multiplied it, then we can get it 48 volt. So here we have learned about the how to find out the current through any resistance. There are several methods to solve this question. You can find the this current or voltage across this by various methods. Here we have applied Norton's theorem. Now we will see that what is the maximum power transfer theorem. This theorem states that power transfer through the load. Load means in any complicated circuit or in any circuit or in any network, if the load is connected and we want to find out the power through this or power delivered to this load, then the power transfer through this load will be maximum when there are some conditions. In case of DC, we say when the load resistance is equal to the equivalent resistance of network. This is the first condition. When we consider the AC network, in this case we say when the load impedance, let us see this, when we talk about the AC circuit, we talk about the impedance. When we talk about the DC circuit, we say resistance. Okay. So in the case of the AC circuit, we can say the load impedance is equal to the complex conjugate of the internal impedance of the network, or internal impedance of the network is equal to the complex conjugate of the load resistance. So these are the some conditions which are necessary for transferring the maximum power through load. So let us consider the, this is the ZS. We are saying this ZS is equal to the source impedance or internal impedance of the network. This is RS plus JXS, and RL, ZL is the load. This is RL plus JXL, where the omega is the frequency of the source. We will discuss about the first condition of the maximum power transfer theorem. Here we are considering this part. Remember one thing, whenever we discuss about the, or we find out the values in case of the maximum power transfer theorem, we always consider this whole network, complicated network, as a Thevenin equivalent or Norton's equivalent. It is generally, we consider the, in general practice, we consider it as a whole network is converted into the one voltage source and the one this internal impedance. See this network. What we want to find out? We want to find out the condition for which the value of the RL, what will be the value of this RL for which power transfer through this RL is maximum. How to select this value? Okay, there are lots of application in electrical and electronics where we want to find out the power transfer through this. Any element should be maximum. First of all, what is the current through this? Current I is equal to Vs divided by Rs plus RL, and power in the load PL is equal to half I square RL. We want to make this power transfer through this load is maximum. Just by putting the value of I, we are getting this equation, PL is equal to this equation. Now, for maximizing the PL, this differentiation of this PL with respect to RL is equal to 0. Here the RL is variable, that means we want to vary this resistance RL for which the power is maximum. So, you know from the mathematics that this is the gradient when the maximum at the maximum point, this gradient will be 0. Now, here that means we are differentiating this equation with respect to RL. When we differentiate this, then you will get this equation, and R finally you will get from this equation RL is equal to RS. So, this is the condition, that means for any network, power transfer through the load will be maximum only when the load resistance is equal to the internal resistance of the network. This is the only case when power transfer will be maximum. Okay? So, the generally we are considering here RL and RS, just we are considering the case of the DC circuits. Now, let us consider the case of the AC circuits. In case of the AC circuits, we generally say the impedances. So, here this is the network total impedance of the network, or this is the source impedance, this is the RS plus JXS. So, this whole complicated circuit is denoted by the single voltage source and the this, and this is the ZL across the terminal AB. We want to find out the maximum delivered power to this ZL should be maximum. So, we are finding the condition for which this, what will be the value of this ZL for which power transfer through this ZL will be maximum. Just the same manner, PL is equal to 1 upon 2 I square RL, this is the power equation. So, here put the value of I is equal to V divided by RS, this RS plus JXS and plus ZL. So, we can write it like this, multiplied by RL, this is nothing. This is ZS is equal to RS plus JXS. When XS is equal to 0, this will be only RS. So, here we can write an equation like this. We are considering the both here. Then, for maximizing this, you know the same condition that gradient should be 0, or we can say the first we can select in this equation. Now, for maximizing PL, just same manner, dPL divided by dRL is equal to 0. So, when you differentiate this equation, you will get RL is with respect to RL, you will get RL is equal to RS. Okay. So, that means both this is equal to R, just like as a case 1 in case of DC we have got. So, here we can say the ZL is equal to RS, ZL equal to what we can say RL plus JXL, where the value of RL is equal to we can say RS, and value of XL is equal to minus XS here. So, here we are putting this. In total, you just understand one thing, that in case of AC circuits, whenever we will say that the power transfer through the load will be maximum, in that case the load impedance should be the complex conjugate of the internal impedance of the network. Complex conjugate means if you are saying the A plus IB, the complex conjugate of A plus IB is A minus IB. Okay? So, here, so this is the maximum power transfer theorem. Now, we will see some application of the maximum power transfer theorem or a problem based on this. There is one more thing. Whenever we will find out the maximum power through any load or power delivered to any load is maximum, in that case the efficiency of the circuit reduced to 50%. Remember one thing. You can say this is sometimes this drawback in case of the electrical circuit, because the efficiency, we are getting the maximum power through the load, but the efficiency reduced to 50%. So, we have to compromise in this thing. So, but in case of electronics in general, where the efficiency is not very important, where the where it is necessary to get the power delivered should be maximum through any element, in that case this theorem is very useful. Maximum power transfer is very useful. And in case of the electrical circuit, we have to compromise with the efficiency. Now, we will see what is the Millman's theorem. This is the another theorem we use in the circuit analysis. The question must be arising in your mind that why do we use this theorem? Generally, in the case of the polyphase circuit, where the some neutral point is there, common point is there, and we want to find out the voltage at that point, in general we use the Millman's theorem there. Or if the combination is given like this, that there are so many sources with their impedances are connected in parallel, and we, that means this whole complicated part where the lot of voltage sources are there and they are connected in parallel with their impedances, then this whole network can be replaced by a equivalent voltage source and a equivalent resistance. You know, it's very simple. Suppose there are 10 sources with their internal resistance of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like this, then you can replace this whole sources into a one equivalent voltage source and one one impedance. So, this can be done with the use of the Millman's theorem. This theorem is very useful in solving the unbalanced polyphase AC networks, wherein the impedances are all connected in star. Millman's theorem helps in finding the potential of the star point or neutral point. So, now what is this theorem? See, if just I have said that if there are large number of sources with EMF like E1, E2, E3, EN, this is the potential of the or EMF of the sources with their internal impedances Z1, Z2, Z3, Zn, and these are connected in parallel as shown in figure. This is just given in next slide. So, then the potential of the common point is given by the Millman's theorem. See this. This is a one voltage source, a one EMF source with its internal impedance Z1, second E2 with internal impedance Z2, and there may be so many sources EN with internal impedance Zn. This whole network can be replaced here at this point into a equivalent voltage source and the equivalent impedance. How? We can derive this thing. Here the value of this voltage source V, suppose we say that this is the value of this voltage source at this point terminal, this V is equal to, we can say like this, E1 Y1 plus E2 Y2, Y1 is what? Y1 is equal to 1 upon Z1, Y2 is 1 upon Z2. Now, how to derive this thing? Okay, remember one thing, when you solve the problem based on the Millman's theorem, you have to remember this equation. See, I1 is equal to, we can say E1 minus V divided by Z1 like this. E1 minus V is a common point, voltage here is V, E1 minus V divided by Z1 is the value of current I1. Similarly, the current I2 is equal to E2 minus V divided by Z2, En minus V divided by Zn is equal to In here. Then at this, according to the Kirchhoff's current law, at this junction, all the currents is equal to 0. So, all are incoming currents. So, I1 plus I2 plus I3 equal to 0 from the Kirchhoff current law. You can say here, put the values here. When you are putting the values here, 1 upon this, you say 1 upon Z1, we can write it Y1. So, here we are writing Y1. This Y2, this is Yn. From this equation, you are getting this, V is equal to this. So, the value of the equivalent voltage source is equal to this. You can put the values here, you know E1, you know Y1, you know this, you know this, and you can get the value of V volt, the equivalent voltage source, from here, from the Millman's theorem. Now, we will see one question based on the Millman's theorem. Okay. Here, this is the network. Determine the current through the branch AB, this is the branch AB, using Millman's theorem. okay. See this, the 2 volt, 4 volt, 6 volt, and their internal impedances correspond to this 2 ohm here, this is the 4 ohm and this 6 ohm. As this is, these are connected in parallel, that means we can apply the Bellman's theorem and we can find out the current through this, because this whole network, this network across the terminal AB, this can be replaced by a equivalent voltage source and the equivalent impedance using the network, this Bellman's theorem. Now let us see the Telligen's theorem. What is this theorem? Basically this theorem is based on the Kirchhoff's current law and the Kirchhoff's current voltage law only. Just see this. If the branch voltages V1, V2 till Vn satisfy all the constraints imposed by the KVL, and if the branch currents I1, I2, In satisfy all the constraints imposed by the KCL, then from the Telligen's theorem states that for k equal to 1 to b, summation of this, k means the branch, from branch 1 to branch b, 1, 2, 3, 4, suppose b equal to 4, so branch 1, branch 2, branch 3, branch 4, multiplication of the voltage source, the voltage across the branch and the current through that branch is equal to 0. So this is the Telligen's theorem. Now some important features of this theorem. The theorem is not concerned with the type of the circuit elements. This is the first feature. The second feature is based on the Kirchhoff's law. I have already told this is the based on the only Kirchhoff's current law and the Kirchhoff voltage law. The reference relation of the branch voltages and the currents are arbitrary, except that they have to satisfy the Kirchhoff's law. So this Telligen's theorem states, which relate the powers in all the branches, is like this. K equal to 1 to b, summation of k equal to 1 to b, that means we are considering the power in all the branches, and the summation of the power in all the branches of the network is equal to 0. This implies that the sum of the powers delivered to all the branches of the network is 0. This is called the Telligen's theorem. Now here let us see the one example based on the Telligen's theorem here. For two circuits, the one circuit is this, second circuit is this, we want to verify the Telligen's theorem. As we have told that the Telligen's theorem states that the power in any branches, this branch for this element, this is the second element, we can say this is the second branch, this is the third branch, and the summation of the power in all the branches is equal to 0, or it should be 0 according to the Telligen's theorem. So we will see whether it is right or wrong. Okay, the solution is this. See, the summation of I equal to 1, 2, 3, we can say for this network, first, second, third, three elements are there. So the power, this is the 10 volt multiplied by current is flowing 2 ampere. We are saying the 2 ampere current is flowing through this circuit. So 10 multiplied by 2, here we can say 3 multiplied by 2, here 7 multiplied by 2, just like the Kirchhoff's, the sign conventions are considered as per the Kirchhoff's voltage law. So here we are saying this is equal to 0, and which is the Telligen's theorem, so this is satisfied. So let us see this part, this is also 0, this is also satisfied. So today we have discussed about the Telligen's theorem, Bellman's theorem, maximum power transfer theorem and their applications, the problem based on these theorems, and what is the use of these theorems, why do we use, in what case, and why we use this theorem in the circuits, and how do we use this. So my dear friends, let us practice on all these theorems. The practice makes man perfect. So okay, goodbye.